फ्रेंड्स सब्सक्राइब कीजिए वाईफाई स्टडी चैनल को और बेल आइकन को दबाइए लेटेस्ट एग्जाम वीडियो सबसे पहले देखने के लिए। हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू वाईफाई स्टडी चेंजिंग द वे ऑफ लर्निंग प्रेजेंट्स करंट अफेयर 2017 अगस्त थर्ड वीक इन इंग्लिश। सो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू प्रोवाइड यू ईच एंड एवरी इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज़ फ्रॉम द थर्ड वीक ऑफ द अगस्त। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द इंटरनेशनल, द नेशनल, ट्रेड एंड बैंकिंग, इकोनॉमिक्स, एवरीथिंग वी आर गोइंग टू कवर इन दिस वीडियो। सो फ्रेंड्स, इफ यू लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज सब्सक्राइब सो दैट वी कैन प्रोवाइड यू मोर वीडियोज, मोर कंटेंट फॉर योर अपकमिंग एग्जाम। So friends, first of all, we are going to cover the international section, all the news which is outside from the India. Okay, that is international. Let's see the first question. Recently, India signed an MOU in the field of intellectual property rights with which one of the following countries? So recently, India signed an MOU in the field of intellectual property. First of all, you need to understand what is this intellectual property. Every property which is related to you. Okay, for example, like copyright. Okay, something you write and you have a script of it, you have a lyrics, and everything which is written by you that should not be copied by someone else is an intellectual property. So India signed an agreement on it. So let's see the news first. An MOU between India and Sweden on cooperation in the field of intellectual property right has been approved by the Union Cabinet. So your answer of this question is none of these, because India signed with the Sweden. Okay, and in this MOU, both countries will going to exchange trade best practices, work together on the training program and technical exchange to raise awareness on IPR and better protect intellectual property rights. Okay, so this is the thing that you need to remember. Another thing which is very important is the WIPO. What is this WIPO? That is World Intellectual Property Organization. Okay, it is one of the 17, it is one of the 17 specialized agencies of the United Nations, as you know that. And was created in WIPO was created in 1967 to encourage creative activity to promote the protection of the intellectual property throughout the world. And right now, this organization has 189 members across the globe. And headquarters of this organization is in Geneva. Okay, it is in Switzerland. And the current Director General of WIPO is Francis Gary. Francis Gary is the current Director General of this organization. So let's see the another news. Which two Indian oil companies have gave order for importing crude oil from USA? So recently what happened, USA allowed India to have a crude oil. As you know that India is among the only few Asian countries that have a facility to import crude oil from USA. The other countries are like South Korea, Japan, China. Okay, all these nations buy American crude oil. So first of all, we are going to see the news first. A new landmark in India-USA relationship. New vistas in the India-USA relationship will begin with the arrival of the first shipment of American crude oil to India by the end of September this year. It is the first lot of the 2 million barrel costing $100 million is a part of the expecting bilateral oil trade to $2 billion. Okay, and recently what happened? OPEC countries raises their prices of the crude oil and they cut their exporting oil also. So that's because of that India have to move towards the USA, and USA also showed a warm welcome to India. Okay, and India is also world third largest oil importer after USA and China. USA and China is the biggest importer of the oil right now, and India is on third position. And the two companies which got this contract is Indian Oil Corporation and Bharat Petroleum. So your answer is C, Indian Oil Corporation and Bharat Petroleum are the two companies who got this order. Which one of the following country will host G7 Interior Minister Summit? Okay, Interior Minister Summit. So we are going to see what is this G7 countries first of all. Italy is going to host this Interior Minister Summit. So your answer of this question is A. And among G7 countries, first is Italy, second Canada, France, Germany, UK, Japan and US. These are the seven countries, okay, which form group named G7. China is not among these. India is also not among these group. Okay, and Italy currently holds the rotating chair of the G7 industrialist nation. And this summit is expected to be held in October. So your answer of this question is A. Which one of the following two states signed Global Environment Facility Grant Agreement to improve forest quality and sustainable land agreement with the World Bank? So recently what happened, India and Indian government and the government of Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh signed an agreement with the World Bank to increase the forest quality, sustainable land management, and for that they also got a loan also. Okay, of $24.64 million grant from the Global Environment Facility. So your answer of this question is Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. So C is your answer. And we are also going to remember the name of the CM and the governor of the Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh also. If we talk about Chhattisgarh, who is the CM of Chhattisgarh? Raman Singh. And who is the governor? Okay, Mr. Tandon is the governor right now. And if we talk about the Madhya Pradesh, okay, as you know that Shivraj Singh Chauhan. Shivraj Singh Chauhan is the CM of the Madhya Pradesh, and who is the governor? Om Prakash Kohli is the governor of the Madhya Pradesh. Let's see another question. Who among the following named as 2017 highest paid female actress? So let's see the news first. Emma Stone has been named Hollywood best paid female actor in Forbes annual list of top earners. Only need to remember the name of an actress who got the highest paid. So your answer is Emma Stone. So C is your answer. In which city China has launched its first cyber court specialization in handling internet related cases? So recently China launches first cyber court in e-commerce hub. And where it is in Hangzhou. Okay, so your answer of this question is Hangzhou. A is your answer. And all the cases which are relevant to the internet and which is relevant to the online trade dispute, copyright lawsuits will be going to handled by this Hangzhou court, e-commerce hub of Hangzhou court. So your answer is A. Where is the first regional center of the new development bank has been opened? So this is very important news, friends, because there are few questions that you have to remember from this part of the story. First of all, what is this new development bank, NDB? Formerly, this bank was known as BRICS Development Bank. And I hope that you know about the BRICS Development Bank. Okay, this is the former name of the new development bank. And what is this BRICS? BRICS is the association of the five nations, comprises of Brazil, Russia, India, China, and South Africa. Okay, so they opened their first regional center in South Africa. So your answer is A, Johannesburg. Okay, and who is the South African president? Jacob Zuma. And you also need to remember that the headquarters of this bank is in Shanghai. Shanghai is in China. Okay, and their first regional office, NDB, will be opened in Johannesburg, South Africa. So let's see another question. Recently, in which one of the following city Festival of India is being organized? So, Festival of India been organized in Côte d'Ivoire, Liberia and Guinea. So, these two nations are African nations, first of all. And where was the Festival of India organized? It is organized in Côte d'Ivoire. So, C is your answer. There are many different diversified Indian culture was shown there. Among that, classical and folk dances was also present at that ceremony. So now we are going to understand the national news. Recently, Indian government asked internet majors to remove Blue Whale Challenge links. What is this Blue Whale Challenge? Okay, so this is a very famous game. Because of that, many life wasn't threatened and few life were also gone because of this in India also. Okay, recently one Jaipur guy was caught while completing the challenge of this Blue Whale. So your answer of this question is game. Okay, it is a game. And this Blue Whale began in Russia in 2013 with what was the previous name and what was the initial name of this game? F57. One of the name of so-called death group of the Wangte social network. Okay, and the first suicide take place in 2015. Philip was a person who is a former psychologist student who was expelled from his university, claimed that he invented the game. Okay, so your answer of this question is B. And who was the inventor? Philip was the person who invented this game. And this Blue Whale Challenge is a reportedly a suicide game in which a player is given certain tasks to complete for a period of 50 days and final task leads to suicide. The player is also asked to share photos after finishing the challenge. Let's see another one. The Union government has imposed $264 million penalty on Reliance Industries for not fulfilling the targeted production of natural gas from which one of the following oil field? Okay, so recently Indian Union government has imposed $264 million penalty on Reliance Industries. Because they didn't produce the natural gas as it was the initial target to produce that. So it was a penalty of nearby 1700 crore rupees and they didn't fulfill the targeted production of natural gas from KG-D6 field in 15 and 16. So your answer is D. KG-D6 field in 2015-16, they didn't produce natural gas as it was targeted. Okay, so because of that, penalty was imposed by the Union government. Let's see another one. Which one of the following authority launched two mobile apps, MyFastAG and FastAG Partner? Another very important question, because recently NHAI, that is National Highway Authority of India, launched two mobile apps, MyFastAG and FastAG Partner in New Delhi to facilitate the availability of the fast tags for electronic toll collection. So this was launched too for toll collection, and the answer of this question is C. And you also need to understand about the NHAI. Yeah, this organization, NHAI, was founded in 1988. What is the purpose of this organization? Okay, to development and the maintenance of the national highway. And headquarters of this organization is in New Delhi. And who is the chairman of this organization right now? Okay, Yadavir Singh Malik. Yadavir Singh Malik is the chairman of this organization right now. Swachh Sankalp Se Swachh Siddhi competition is organized by. So there is a one competition which was started. Name of that competition is Swachh Sankalp Se Swachh Siddhi. Okay, in pursuit of achieving New India by 2022, first of all, you also need to remember the government plan of New India is by 2022. Okay, under Sankalp and Siddhi vision, the Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation is organizing countrywide film, essay and painting competition only for primary school students between 17 and 8 September. So your answer of this question is Ministry of Drinking Water and Sanitation is a ministry which is organizing this competition. Navika Sagar Parikrama is a project where a team of women officers of the Indian Navy would circumnavigate the globe on an Indian boat named. So friends, recently what is going on? Navika Sagar Parikrama is a project which is a team of women officers of the Indian Navy. They are going to for a circumnavigation of the whole globe on an Indian built sailboat. So you need to remember the name of that Indian sailboat. Okay, there are two sailboats that you need to remember. First is the Tarani. This is the name of the sailboat that they are going to their journey or odyssey. So your answer of this question is C. And this is a sister vessel of the INSV Madhai. Okay, so these are the two names that you need to remember. And this expedition has been applied titled Navika Sagar Parikrama, aimed at promoting women empowerment in the country and ocean sailing by the Indian Navy. The expedition would inspire the youth of our nation to develop an understanding of the sea and instill a spirit of adventure and camaraderie. Let's see another question. Champion of Change initiative has been organized by which ministry institution? So recently, Champion of Change. And who is the Champion of Change? Entrepreneurs are the Champion of Change. As you know that, from the 2014-15, there is a lot of startup which was started in India. And they did a fabulous job to providing jobs, employment, okay, technology to our nation. So because of that, PM Modi set them as a Champion of Change. And this initiative was organized by Niti Aayog. Okay. It is a think tank of the government of India. As you know that Niti Aayog is also known as the think tank of the nation, okay, or government of India. And what is the full form of Niti? Name of the full form of the Niti is a National Institution for Transforming India. Okay, and it was replaced by Planning Commission, which followed the top-down model. So what was Planning Commission was approaching the top-down model. And by reverse of that, Niti Aayog is following down to top model. Okay, so they also want to, the aim for Niti Aayog is to create a foster involvement and participation in the economic policy making progress by the state government also. And emphasis is on, as I told you, bottom up approach and to make the country to move towards cooperative federalism. Okay, and it was established in 2015, 1st January 2015, and first meeting was held on 8th February 2015. And who is the ex-officio chairman of this organization? PM. RPM is the ex-officio chairman. Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman of this organization. CEO of this organization is Amir Tapkant. Previously, Arvind Pangaria was the vice chairman. He resigned, and right now Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman. Apart from it, there are three members also, like Deepak Dibroy, VK Saraswat and Ramesh Chand. These are the members of this Niti Aayog. Okay. So your answer to this question is Niti Aayog. E is your answer. Who is the deputy CM of Tamil Nadu? Okay, so recently there is one deputy CM was made of Tamil Nadu. So you need to remember the CM name also and the deputy name also. So OPS Sonin as a TN, Tamil Nadu deputy CM. So your answer is O. Paneerselvam. OPS is the another name of this person. And he was made as deputy CM of the Tamil Nadu. And who is the CM? Panali Swami is the CM of this state. And governor is the Vidyasagar Rao. And capital is the Chennai. Okay, so these are the two things that you need to remember. Now let's see finance news. Where has been the National Workshop on Enforcement of Intellectual Property Right organized? So first of all, we are going to see the news. So National Capital on Enforcement of Intellectual Property Rights was organized. The Cell for IPR Promotion and Management, that is CIPAM, is a professional body, okay, under the aegis of Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, that is DIPP, which comes under the Ministry of Commerce and Industry. So first of all, these are the department ministry which you need to remember. First of all, Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Okay, under this Ministry of Commerce and Industry, there is another department, that is the name of the department is Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion, and one professional body, that is the CIPAM, comes under the Department of Industrial Policy and Promotion. The name of the department, the professional body, is the Cell for IPR Promotion and Management. Okay, so they are organized in New Delhi. So your answer to this question is New Delhi, first of all. And enforcement agencies like police, custom, and also the prosecution wing has a major role to play in the effective enforcement of IPR in the country. So let's see another news. Where is the Swasth Bachche Swasth Bharat program, an initiative of the Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan launched? So this is the program named Swasth Bachche Swasth Bharat program, and it is an initiative of the Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. It was launched in Kochi. So your answer is A. Okay, HRD, who is the HRD minister? Shri Prakash Javedkar launches Swasth Bachche Swasth Bharat. It is an initiative which is of Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan to prepare a physical health and fitness profile card for more than 12 lakhs of Kendriya Vidyalaya students was launched in Kochi. And Swachh Bachche Swasth Bharat program will provide a comprehensive and inclusive report card for children covering all age group and children of different abilities. Let's see another question. Which one of the following is the name of cloud seeding project of the Karnataka? So what is this cloud seeding, first friends? It is a method of artificial rainfall. Okay, first of all, this is the thing you need to understand. There are several questions asked over this. And what is the name of cloud seeding project of Karnataka? Karnataka is doing a cloud seeding. Okay, and the name of that project is Varshadhare. So your answer of this question is B, Varshadhare. Okay, this is a cloud seeding project of Karnataka, took off at Jhakar Airfield. The project name Varshadhare has been fully operational, taken up for a period of 60 days. And what is this cloud seeding? Once again, we are going to say it is a technique employed to increase precipitation in the clouds. Experts say precipitation in the cloud has been affected recently due to the increase in the particulate matter in the atmosphere, among other factors. And cloud seeding aim at catalyzing the process of precipitation so that the rainfall could be increased by 15-20% in the drought affected areas of the state. And the impurities which was added in this method is silver iodide and potassium chloride. And the objective is to increase the size of the droplets in large enough to fall down as rain. So these are the few things that you need to remember. Which one of the following government institution launched the Mentor India campaign? So Niti Aayog launches Mentor India campaign, and I told you everything about the Niti Aayog in the previous question. So your answer of this question is D. It is a Mentor India campaign, and Niti Aayog launched the Mentor India campaign, a strategic nation building initiative to engage leaders who can guide and mentor students at more than 900 Atal Thinking Labs established across the country as a part of Atal Innovation Mission. CEO of the Niti Aayog, that is Shri Abhitabh Kant, unveiled the online nationwide initiative in the capital. So this is the aim to increase the innovation in the country, basically. Okay. Let's see another one. Which one of the following government launches Shri Means Business program of Facebook for women entrepreneurs? So Odisha government and Facebook launches Shri Means Business program. It is a business program for women. Okay, we know women entrepreneurs, and under this scheme, 25,000 women entrepreneurs and self-help groups member will be going to give training on digital marketing skills within 1 year. So your answer is D. Okay, let's see another one. How many Indian companies are among a list of 200 largest publicly traded entities that are making significant revenue from clean energy? So as you know that there are different companies across the globe who is making solar energy, clean energy as their part of project. So there are 7 Indian companies among 200 in green energy revenues. So your answer of this question is 7. And India is also among the top 11 countries. Okay, as 7 of their companies are among the 200 largest publicly traded entities that are making their significant revenue from the clean energy. And India ranked 5th after China, US, Japan, Germany. Okay, let's see another one. Which one of the following bank launches its first CSR initiative, Gram Seva? So what is this CSR? CSR is a corporate social responsibility initiative. It is a part of a company. Okay, that they have to invest some amount of their profit into the CSR. So SBI gives a leg up to CSR initiative, and the name of their initiative is Gram Seva, which will work in the areas of health, education, environment, and rural infrastructure. So your answer of this question is SBI. Okay, and the head of this organization is Arundhati Bhattacharya. And there are a few things also that you need to remember from the SBI. The headquarters of the SBI is in Mumbai, as you know that. And in April 2017, SBI, which is India's largest, merged with the 5 of its associate bank also. And initially, it was started in 1806 as a bank of Calcutta. After that, in 1921, it was converted into the Imperial Bank of India. And in 1955, it was converted into the SBI. Okay, and in 1956, it was nationalized. So these are the few things that you need to remember. That's another one. Which of the following telecom company launched digital wallet in partnership with the MobiWink? So another PSU named BSNL launches digital wallet in partnership with MobiWink. State-owned Bharat Sanchar Nigam went digital by launching a mobile wallet app that would enable its existing 100 million customer to make bill payment and transact on e-commerce platform. And who is the head of the BSNL right now? CMD of the BSNL, Anupam Srivastava, is the CMD of BSNL. So your answer is D. Which one of the following company has become the first power utility to introduce a QR code based bill payment system in India? So Tata Power has become the first power utility to introduce a QR code based bill payment system in India. The company said through its financiality of the bill payment through a QR code has been introduced in other services industries. It will be launched in power industry for the first time in India by the Tata Power. Okay, it is in the first time in India. So your answer is D. A motif of Hampi with carriots on the reserve in the feature of which new rupees denomination bank notes. So as you know that there are two newly note published by the RBI, 150 rupees note and another one is a 200 rupee note. So the motif of Hampi monuments were made on rupees 50. So your answer is C. Okay, so Reserve Bank will soon release rupees 50 denomination bank notes in the Mahatma Gandhi series having signature of the Ajit Patel. And the base color of the new note is fluorescent blue. It is a motif of Hampi with carriots in the reverse, depicting the culture, country's culture heritage. And what is Hampi? It is a village and temple town recognized as a UNESCO World Heritage Site also, listed as a group of monuments at Hampi in northern Karnataka, India. It is located where the ruin of the city of the Vijayanagar also, a former capital of the Vijayanagar Empire. Okay, and there is one famous temple is also available at there, that is Viru Prakash Temple. So the answer of this question is C. For which state NABARD has sanctioned a loan assistance of rupees 1300 crore for creation of rural infrastructure in the state under the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund? So recently NABARD sanctioned rupees 1350 crore loan to Rajasthan government. Okay, so now what is the full form of NABARD? National Bank of Agriculture and Rural Development has sanctioned a loan assistance of rupees 1300 crore to the Rajasthan government for creation of a rural infrastructure in the state under the Rural Infrastructure Development Fund. So your answer is Rajasthan. Who is the CM? Vasundhara Raja is the CM of the Rajasthan and governor is the Kalyan Singh. Okay, and if we talk about the NABARD, this organization was founded in 1982. Headquarter of this organization is in Mumbai. And who is the chairman of this organization? Harish Kumar Banwala is the chairman of this organization. India receives maximum FDI from which one of the following countries? So as you know that there are many startups, many investment from the neighboring, many investment from the European and the American companies. So foreign direct investment FDI into the country grew up by 37% to 10.4 billion US dollar during the first quarter of the current fiscal. And the countries which are among the FDI, top list in the FDI is Singapore, Mauritius, Netherlands, Japan. So your answer to this question is Singapore. Singapore is among the maximum among the countries which invested maximum in India. Now let's see some appointment question. Who among the following appointed as a MD and CEO of IFCI Limited? So as you know that what is this IFCI? It is a Industrial Finance Corporation of India. It is an Indian government owned development bank to cater to long-term finance need of the industrial sector. And it was the first development finance institution also, friends, it was established by the Indian government after independence. Okay, and right now Shankara Rao is the new chief executive of IFCI. So your answer is B. Dr. Mamata Suri has been taken charge of ED of which one of the following institution? So Dr. Mamata Suri takes charge of the executive director of IBBI. And what is this IBBI? It is the Insolvency and the Bankruptcy Board of India. So your answer is A, IBBI. Okay, and what is this IBBI? We are also going to see this. IWBI, okay, it was established in 2016 and given statutory power through the Insolvency and Bankruptcy Code, and which was passed by the Lok Sabha also in 2016. It covers individual, companies, limited liabilities, partnership, partnership firms, and this new code will speed up the resolution process for the stressed assets in the country. What are the stressed assets? The assets which are in the position which is not able to grow up also and not able to end up their business also, so that are assets are known as stressed assets. Okay, and it attempts to simplify the process of insolvency and bankruptcy proceeding. So because of that, this organization was made, named IWBI. Okay, so your answer of this question is A. Who among the following appointed as the interim CEO of Infosys? So friends, as you know that Infosys Limited is an Indian multinational corporation that provide business consulting, information technology, outsourcing services, and its headquarter is in Bangalore. And in this company, Infosys, it is India's second largest Indian IT firm, okay, by 2016 revenue. And Vishal Sikka resigned as MD and CEO of Infosys, and currently UB Praveen Rao is currently the chief operating officer, is also responsible for the CEO position. Okay, so right now COO and CEO both is the same person, named Praveen Rao. Who among the following is appointed as a president and MD of GM India? Okay, so as you know that GM India is also a very famous international company, which is a American company. Okay, and what is their work? They work in the designing, manufacturing, market and distributes vehicles and vehicle parts. So who is the founder of this GM company? William Duran and Charles Mott are the founder of this GM company, and the headquarter of it is, this GM is in Michigan, USA. And who is the India head? Sanjeev Gupta. Sanjeev Gupta is the appointed as a president and MD of GM India. Who is appointed as a DG of Railway Protection Force, Railway Board? So Dharmendra Kumar, IPS officer, is appointed as a Director General, Railway Protection Force, Railway Board. Presently, he is working in CISF as additional DG. So your answer of this question is Dharmendra Kumar. Dr. Pinaki, a US-based doctor, has discovered an inexpensive prevention technique against. So as you know that there is a one disease, if you heard about it, there is a one disease named sepsis. Okay, it is a life-threatening illness disease. So your answer of this question is A. So this is a person, Dr. Pinaki, who made an inexpensive prevention technique to counterattack this sepsis. Okay, previously it was a very expensive, technique or prevention methods for this newborn baby's disease, sepsis. And he made this technique very cheap. Which one of the following latest Android mobile operating system has been released by Google? So recently, Android Oreo released by the Google, and it is the latest version of its Android mobile operating system, named after the Oreo chocolate biscuits. Okay, so your answer of this question is C. And in addition to this, there is a picture-in-picture mobile mode that lets some app run in a small corner of the screen. And Google-owned Nexus and Pixel phones are expected to be the first to receive the software update. Okay, so as you know that all over the nation, all over the globe, there are two most famous operating system. One is the Android and second is the iOS. Now let's see some awards question. Who has been selected for the prestigious Agriculture Leadership Award 2017? So Telangana CM chosen for the Agriculture Leadership Award. So your answer of this question is Chandrasekhar Rao. Telangana CM, that is Chandrasekhar Rao, has been selected for the prestigious Agriculture Leadership Award 2017. Okay, and the committee headed by the agriculture scientist M.S. Swaminathan, who is also known as the father of the Green Revolution, has recommended the CM name because of their work, because of his welfare of farmers and farm sector. This award was given to him. Who among the following player has been selected for this year Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award? So there are different names that you need to remember from the National Sports Award 2017 as it was announced. First of all, there are two important names that you need to remember. First is the Paralympian Devendra Jajaria, who is from Rajasthan, and another one, hockey player Sardar Singh, who has been selected for this year Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Award. And this award is given to the sports person for spectacular and most outstanding performance in the field over a period of 4 years. And different Arjun awardee are like Harmanpreet Kaur, Cheteshwar Pujara, Prakash, Devendra Singh, tennis player Saket, and there are other 17 sports person who will be given Arjun Award this year. Okay, and there is Dronacharya Award is also, and you need to remember that Rajiv Gandhi Khel Ratna Arjun Award are given to performance over a period of 4 years, and Dronacharya is given to coaches And Dhyan Chand Award is given for lifetime contribution to sports achievement. Okay, and your answer of this question is Devendra Jajaria. Now let's see some sports question. Where under 19 Cricket World Cup 2018 will be held? Another very important question, because New Zealand will host ICC under 19 Cricket World Cup 2018. So your answer of this question is New Zealand. And where is the headquarter of ICC? It is in Dubai. And a team of 16 players will be participated in the upcoming World Cup. Who among the following Indian shuttlers clinched the Bulgaria Open International Series in the men's singles? So Indian young shuttler Lakshya Sen clinched the Bulgaria Open International Series title after notching up a hard-fought win over Croatia Zomimir Dujevic in a men's singles final in Sofia. So your answer of this question is E, Lakshya Sen. Who among the following continue to be the world top ranked one day batsman in the latest ICC ODI ranking? So if we talk about the latest ODI ranking in the world, then Virat Kohli continues to the top ICC ODI ranking for batsman. So your answer of this question is D. And among bowler, Bhuvneshwar Kumar is on top position with, okay, and he is on 13th rank. And if we talk about the ODI team ranking, India is on 3rd position. Who among the following won a bronze medal in the double trap event at the IISSF Junior Shotgun World Cup? So Sampath Bhardwaj win bronze at the Junior Shotgun World Cup. So your answer is D. Now let's see some next question. Jerry Lewis was recently died. With which field he was related? So legendary comic artist Jerry Lewis, who was known for his brash lipstick on humor, was died at the age of 91. He was one of the Hollywood most entertaining comedian whose career spanned for more than 6 decades. So your answer of this question is comedy. Now let's see some books question. The book I Am HIV Positive, So What has been written by whom? So friend, this is a very important book, and you have to remember that this book is written by the Mr. World Bronze Medalist. Okay, the name of that person is Pradi Kumar Singh. Pradi Kumar Singh is a bodybuilder hailing from Manipur. So Manipur bodybuilder announced this condition in this new book documenting his career. And this new book documents the career of a brave man and his continuous struggle against the hideous HIV virus. Having been a victim of the virus for over a decade now, the brave man one's ambition in life is to be a role model for all HIV sufferers. Okay, currently he is a brand ambassador of HIV AIDS for the Manipur state also. And he was detected as being HIV positive in year 2000. He had contracted the virus from a shared syringe, a result of being a drug addict during his youth. So your answer of this question is C. Okay, he is an inspiration for all the HIV positive persons. So friends, these are the important questions from the third week of the August. I hope you liked it, and you will definitely subscribe us so that I can provide you more videos for upcoming exam. Hope you like this video, and you will definitely subscribe us. So friends, thank you.